The small town of Libby, Montana is once again making big headlines this week as the EPA declared a public health emergency in Libby related to the Asbestos Superfund site located just outside of the town. The announcement marks the very first time in United States history that the Environmental Protection Agency has declared a site to be a public health emergency. Along with the EPA's declaration will come millions of dollars in federal aid to the area, which will help residents obtain much-needed medical assistance. As well, the declaration will bring more aggressive cleanup efforts to the Asbestos Superfund site, the town of Libby, and as well the neighboring town of Troy, Montana, which has also been contaminated with asbestos. The EPA's declaration is a much-awaited chapter of good news for the city of Libby in a complicated story that has been fraught with nothing but bad. For 70 years, the town of Libby was home to one of the world's largest vermiculite mines. Now, vermiculite is a mineral that was used for many different things, but despite its usefulness, the vermiculite mined in Libby, Montana also contained tremolite asbestos, one of the most toxic forms of asbestos. During its operation, the mine in Libby produced more than 70% of the vermiculite sold in the United States. That gives us an idea of just how big this particular mine was. Now, until 1990, mining operations continued in Libby, Montana, routinely spewing hazardous asbestos dust into the town's air supply and onto the mine workers' clothes and body. The resulting effect of decades and decades of asbestos exposure has been absolutely devastating to the towns of Libby and as well the town of Troy, Montana. In fact, thousands of asbestos-related diseases and hundreds of deaths have already been linked to the hazardous condition in Libby, and doctors have estimated that as many as one-fourth, 25% of the area's population have or will develop an asbestos-related disease. Likewise, studies have found that the area's death rate from asbestos-related diseases is 40 times, that's 40, higher than the national average. And just to be clear, we're not talking about the actual mine workers here. We're talking about the entire town. Studies of the Libby area have found that 70% of the people that have already developed asbestos diseases in Libby never even worked at the mine. The EPA's declaration of the public health emergency comes on the heels of the recent acquittal of three W.R. Grace executives charged in connection with the pollution in Libby. From 1963 until the mine's closing in 1990, W.R. Grace, the chemical giant which has also notoriously been linked to groundwater contamination in Woburn, Massachusetts, as was made public by the book and movie A Civil Action, also owned and operated the Libby asbestos mine and severely polluted the Libby community for years and years. In 2005, a federal grand jury in Montana indicted the W.R. Grace Company for its role in the contamination of Libby, along with seven of the company's top-level executives in what became the country's largest environmental crimes case ever. The indictment alleged that the executives knew about the dangers of the asbestos and engaged in a conspiracy to cover up such harms from the mine workers as well as from the townspeople. As well, the grand jury found that W.R. Grace and its executives attempted to impede the EPA's investigation when the EPA began looking into Libby, Montana in 1999. The case finally went to trial this year in 2009 against the three defendants that still remained. But after months of evidence, even including testimony by mine workers and townspeople of Libby, explaining how W.R. Grace duped them into believing that the asbestos was safe for their community, the Missoula, Montana jury ultimately acquitted the executives of the federal charges, sending shockwaves of disapproval and disbelief throughout the Libby community. Now, we weren't in that courtroom, and it's very difficult to judge or criticize a verdict of this magnitude, even though on its face it appears to ignore what happened to the citizens of Libby, Montana. But when we hear accounts of mine workers in Libby, Montana describe how they were reassured time and time again by W.R. Grace that the vermiculite was safe and that tremolite asbestos was not even a harmful type of asbestos, when we hear accounts of how W.R. Grace encouraged townspeople to use vermiculite for many of Libby's projects, including tracks, parks, and playgrounds, when we hear accounts of how W.R. Grace provided workers with respiratory equipment that did not work properly and then still allowed their employees to work without masks, we've got to learn that there's a bigger point, a bigger lesson here that revolves around the idea of trust. What appears consistent in the accounts of Libby residents are the trust and the deference that was given to W.R. Grace by the community, and the belief that the company was always going to act with the people and the town of Libby in mind. After all, Libby was a small town, and it was lucky to have the economic boost that a big corporation like W.R. Grace could provide. But in the end, it was all about economics to W.R. Grace, not about the people of Libby, Montana. It's an old adage that we should never trust someone just trying to make a quick buck. Well, what about a chemical company out to make 140 million bucks? Those are the profits that W.R. Grace made off the Libby asbestos mine. I guess the lesson learned from Libby, Montana is that we cannot just blindly trust big corporations to always do the best thing for the communities they operate in. It's not a bad thing, but it's important to remember that these mega corporations are set up for one primary purpose, and that purpose is simple: to make money. And as such, we have to deal with them at arm's length. We have to question what they tell us about our health and our safety and what's the best thing for us. Time and time again, we've seen that this is particularly true when we're talking about asbestos corporations, where the motives are bigger, the profits are larger, and the risks are deadlier.
When you go to hire a lawyer, you know, you ask the question of what should you look for? Look for his experience. Look for the results he gets. And then you ask, well, how do you know? You go to his website, you Google him, you do Wikipedia. How important is it who your lawyer is? Probably as important as anything in your case. It's hard to understand unless you talk to judges just how significant it is to have a good lawyer.